I'll look after you.
How can you in here?
Because I'm being released on Monday. That's how.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure.
And you're like the rest. Never stay out of trouble for long.
Oh, look, Mum, I know what I'm doing. I've been keeping my nose clean, see? Can't wait to get out of this stinking hole and all them smart-ass bitches. Hate the bloody lot of them. Well, they're in for a big shock.
Oh, there you go again.
Look, Mum, I know what I'm doing. They won't catch me this time.
Look, Meg, you're lonely. You've admitted that. Well, my private life isn't exactly a great social whirl. So what is wrong with two lonely people getting together occasionally, and if it leads to other things, well, what's the harm?
Loneliness isn't a good basis for a relationship, you know that. Look what happened to Vera.
Look, I'm not saying it's ideal, but it's a start, isn't it?
It's a start.
Well, say yes.
I don't know.
Friends? Can I come around tonight?
Right.
A lot of people don't realize that many of the women here find it very difficult to cope with the outside world once they've been released. And they need a refuge, a kind of hiding place while they learn to readjust to the realities of the new lives. And somewhere they can be sure of finding a helpful hand and a friendly face. In short, a halfway house. Ladies and gentlemen, I have no intention of boring all of you with yet another speech. I just want to say this. The color television set here is a symbol, nothing more, of the help that I hope to be able to provide from time to time for the women of Wentworth. It is not an act of charity on my behalf, but a gift to them from a friend.
This is monstrous. How could they? And you talk mean of helping these creatures. They're nothing more than animals.
My aunt, please, it's not...
We've made the papers.
How bad is it?
Oh, we have a comic here. He's treating it as a joke.
Well, it's better than dramatizing it.
Perhaps you don't care that the entire prison service is being held to ridicule?
Well, no one could say that.
The department already has. They've just been on the phone and they hold me personally responsible.
It was Mrs. De Vere who started the whole thing.
But I invited the press. No, it's my own fault. I forgot the type of woman we're dealing with. I am cancelling all privileges until further notice.
They'll understand that.
Yes, I think they will.
Does that mean you're stopping work and study release?
It does.
Oh, but Lynn Warner and Karen Travis
were... They must have known about it, Meg. But they played deaf, dumb and blind. It's about time they all learned a lesson.
Well, Travis and Warner will be...
stop them. And report back here as soon as you've done that. We are holding a spot check on every cell and dormitory till we find whatever it was they used to smash that TV set.
Never seen her so angry.
Yes, she's finally woken up.
So unlike Mrs. Davidson, she's usually so reasonable. There must be something else bugging her.
Look, she's been made a public laughingstock by a bunch of crims. What do you expect her to do? Pat them on the back? Now you go and look in the dormitories and I'll check at the desk. You can stop that. Nobody's going anywhere. All privileges have been cancelled.
Why?
Oh, look, don't act dumber than you already are, Warner. Now get back to your cells. Both of you.
They can't do that.
Oh, yes, they can.
But it's not fair.
What did you expect after yesterday? Heads were bound to roll.
Look, we weren't even involved.
No innocent bystanders in this place, Lynn. Come on. Thought you'd be in the laundry.
I thought you'd be out in the town.
Oh, privileges cancelled.
Oh, tough. Nice day for it, too. Hey, tell me, what do you do when you get out there?
Oh, go to my lectures, go to the library, Sit on the grass, eat my lunch.
Oh, you're a regular little tearaway, aren't you? Don't you ever nick off and have some fun?
I have fun. Just breathing the air outside's fun.
Yeah, but what about the blokes?
What blokes?
Well, the place must be thick with blokes. Talk, talk, talk. I can hardly get a word in edgewise.
Oh, Bea, I've got to study. If you want company, go to the laundry.
Oh, with that goddard dame big-noting herself all over the place, I'd puke in the dryer.
What's Clara ever done to you?
Oh, they think she's Christmas, so that's stupid. But just you wait. She'll come the proverbial, you'll see.
But what's she done?
She got us into strife, didn't she?
Oh, you don't think she smashed the television?
All I'm saying is it wouldn't have happened if I'd been in charge. Madam Clara. Couldn't run a sewing bee.
Well, do you know who did it?
I've got a pretty good idea. I'm not stupid. And I know everything that goes on here. Now, take that doctor boyfriend of yours, for instance. Oh. Not interested?
Bea, he's not my boyfriend.
Oh, then it's no skin off your nose, then, is it?
It's no skin off my nose.
That he's having it off with one of the screws.
I'd say my nose was unaffected.
Huh.
Which one?
Oh, no, you didn't want to know.
Oh. On your feet. I want you two out of here. Smith, you go to the laundry. Travis, you can study in the recreation room.
Hey, you all right now, Mrs. Jackson?
Thank you.
That was a nasty bump on the head she got, you know. I'm glad the doctor's looking after you all right.
Not only no colour TV, now we've got no TV at all. And it's not as though we done it either.
It's iniquitous. I mean, why should you all be punished because of one foolish girl? It's so unfair.
You tell them, Tinkerbell.
You know, you'd think that she'd have the common sense to confess.
Oh, yes, she'd be dead certain to do that.
Well, don't you think so?
Who, me? Are you talking to me?
I thought you said something.
She's like a girl guide in a brothel. She hasn't got a clue.
Well, you don't need a clue if you've got an education.
I've never claimed that education could take the place of practical experience. Bea, you know this prison inside out. Why don't you find who's responsible?
Why should I?
Well, why not? I mean, we're all being punished for something we didn't do.
But you're the big cheese around here. Now, why don't you do it? And while you're at it, you can have a word with the governor and straighten her out as well.
Very well, I will. Erica is going about this the wrong way.
Isn't she marvellous? Bloody marvellous.
Where was it?
In the shower block. Stuff behind one of the toilets. Anyone could have hidden it there.
In that case, the ban on privileges remains.
Well, do you think that's a good idea? I mean, the guilty party may not still be in the prison.
Why do you say that?
Well, anyone who had to stop in here would hardly smash up a TV set. Now, Norlene Burke was released this morning. You know how she felt about everybody.
We don't know it was her. Any one of them could have been responsible for it.
I agree. The ban on privileges remains. That is all.
Can you spare a tiny moment, please, Erica?
What are you doing here?
Well, I wouldn't insist, but it's so important. Now, please don't think I'm being unduly critical, but was it necessary to ban all privileges? They long for TV, the poor things. They haven't anything else, you see.
Are you here as the prisoner's elected representative?
Well, yes, I suppose I am, really.
Then I suggest you go back and tell them that until they are willing to accept responsibility for one another's actions, they will have to suffer the consequences of those actions.
But isn't that being a tiny bit unfair? Wouldn't it be more positive for you to channel your efforts into finding the guilty party?
Are you telling me how to run this prison?
Oh, no, no, I'm just offering suggestions. I promised the girls I would, you see.
It appears to me you are undermining my authority.
Is hardline authority wise, Erica? Isn't it counterproductive? I mean, you know as well as I do that you can catch more flies with honey than with vinegar.
You will stop calling me Erica. You will address me as Governor or Mrs. Davidson. You will speak only when you are spoken to, and you will not have the impertinence to come to this office without an appointment.
Oh, dear.
My advice to you is to keep out of my way and not compound the damage you have already done.
Damage me?
You have abused privileges I have given you. You who should have set an example. Because of you, I have exposed my officers to ridicule and the department to humiliation. I lay yesterday's debacle wholly and solely at your door.
But it wasn't a debacle until the very end. We were all having a wonderful time, and they were all very enthusiastic about my halfway house project. I mean, you were yourself. You made a marvelous speech to the media.